Susan Calman.
Poo, 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 poo.
Your very own cruising companion.
Let's get going.
I love cruises.
Hello!
Almost as much as I love Christmas.
It's important to make an effort.
So, over the next two nights, I'll be jingling all the way.
Oh, oh.
To Norway's winter wonderland.
It's like I'm in the middle of a real-life snow globe.
I'll make new festive friends.
Oh, it's buzzing!
Shop for Christmas essentials. And find the true spirit of Christmas.
It's unbelievable!
Wherever I can.
I get drunk really easily. I'm a very cheap date.
Tonight, I'm cruising from Norway's wintry south to its frozen north. There's a boatload of festive fun.
So I've got some paper chains.
I meet the lively locals in my very first stop.
Oh, that's gonna smart.
Get all crafty in magical Lofoten.
It's a little bit lopsided, kind of like myself.
And meet Santa's helpers deep within the Arctic Circle.
I'm not frightened of reindeers. I want to make that clear. There she is, the MS Maud. Doesn't she look beautiful? Let's get going.
I'm in Dover to start my festive voyage on this little beauty. At a little over 16,000 tonnes, she's the perfect size to navigate Norway's narrow fjords. For the next 15 days, she'll be my home sweet home for a Christmas cruise to the Arctic Circle.
Hang on. I think I need to get into the spirit of things, don't you? That's better. I can't see anything in this beard.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. After crossing the North Sea, we'll start our Norwegian adventure in Stavanger. Venture north to Orlesund, then onwards to Rena and Svalvay on the magical Lofoten Islands before arriving right at the top of the country in chilly Tromsø.
Nearly there.
Our ship is an expedition craft named in honour of the one once used by the famous Norwegian explorer Lovald Amundsen. He was the first person to reach the South Pole, and coincidentally, I'm the first person to arrive for the cruise.
Here we go. It says it's a suite. Absolutely perfect for a woman of such dignity, such as myself. This is lovely. My goodness. It's just beautiful. It's glamorous. It's old-time glamour. It's very much like myself, very much like Marlene Dietrich, who I model myself on. Let me just check. Yes, it's suede. It is. I love a tactile wall. I don't know why.
Keep that to yourself. Anyway, let's get unpacked.
It's all the essentials. Christmas has started.
Time to explore the rest of the ship before it fills up with my fellow passengers.
It's not one of the huge cruise ships, but that makes it quite manageable to find your way around. Morning.
Morning.
It's looking nice and Christmassy around here. It's the perfect Calman height. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Such an itchy nose. I know Santa usually goes down a chimney, but I'm going down in the lift instead. Hi! Here we are, floor 5. So here is a beautiful model of the ship we're on. Now, we're on deck 5 just now, the helipad on top. So that's my room there. I'm there, but I'm also here.
I've got my bearings. The chipolatas and Christmas crackers have been loaded. and the rest of the passengers are on board. As the sun sets over Dover, we are ready to sail away.
Hello, my fellow travellers. How are you? I'm Susan, by the way. Nice to meet you all. Are you excited about this Arctic cruise?
Very.
What are you most looking forward to?
Freezing cold weather and the northern lights.
Yes. Yeah.
I want to lay on the deck and look up at the northern lights.
Is that what you're going to be doing?
Yeah, you have to do it.
Can I?
Yeah.
I don't know what to expect, to be honest, the further north we go. Yeah. But I think it's going to be a huge amount of fun, don't you?
It is.
Here's to what's to come. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers to lying on the deck. Maybe later tonight. Who knows? The ship is just about to leave, and I've got goosebumps already, not because it's cold, but because I can feel the Christmas spirit all around me. There is so much to look forward to. I just can't wait. And did you hear that? I think that was a sleigh bell. We're moving.
It's a new day, and our search for a Scandi winter wonderland has really begun. After leaving Dover, we've sailed 627 nautical miles over the North Sea. And now, on the horizon, we can finally see Norway and the port of Stavanger.
The ship is just about to dock in our first port on the cruise, and I am over the moon.
Stavanger is on Norway's southwest coast, but it's the furthest north I've ever been. And I can't wait to start exploring this city.
About to set foot in Norway for the first time. There we go. How wonderful. I'm in Norway.
And they've certainly gone to town for Christmas here. The old town is a mix of modern with ancient and has 173 preserved wooden buildings. It's also home to one of Europe's largest collections of street art. And this motley crew, who are reenacting the dramatic Viking battle of Havsfjord. I hope they're friendly.
Oh, that's gonna smart.
Right. Time to turn on the Calman charm. Let's meet the locals. Coming up, I head towards a winter wonderland deep in the Arctic Circle. But first,
listen, hear the angels sing.
I'm moved by Christmas carolers
Christmas Day.
And pushed to the limit.
Thank you, I can do it. I can do it.
When I go in search of Norway's breathtaking beauty.
It's gorgeous.
Welcome back to my Christmassy cruise up the Norwegian coast in search of our winter wonderland. I'm at our first stop, Stavanger, in Norway's southwest, meeting some rather lively locals.
We were just testing your courage. Who are you, a stranger in our town?
I'm Susan, I'm from Scotland, I'm a friend.
We welcome you to Stavanger, the Viking capital of Norway, and we are the Hafrsfjord Vikings, the bravest and most courageous warriors in Norway.
You're all very brave. I got a bit of a fright when you came towards me. But thank you for the lovely warm welcome to this beautiful place.
Thank you for visiting.
No, my pleasure. Yeah. You're so polite for a Viking.
Of course. Oh, yeah, we are. Beautiful girls, we always polite.
No, shut up. Thanks very much indeed.
Enjoy your stay in Stavanger and enjoy your trip.
Thank you.
Yes.
Roar! I was frightening myself there. One more time.
Roar!
Thank you.
After all that rah-ing, I need to calm down with a bit of relaxing retail therapy, and I'm in the perfect place. Locals call this street Foigegata, or the Street of Colours, due to its bright paint job. And it's got some pretty boutiques, very handy for Christmas shopping.
Through here, I can already see the most gorgeous Christmas display with this wonderful tree. I mean, even the most grinchiest of people would think this looked lovely. My eye is immediately drawn to this donut. I mean, who else is going to have a donut on their Christmas tree? What else have we got round here? Hold on a second. This might be the winner. One of the best Christmas presents I ever got in my life was a pair of disco roller boots. What could scream Christmas more than a glittery disco roller boot?
Further down the street of many colours, Christmas is in full swing.
Long time ago in Bethlehem.
A barbershop quartet. And given they're outside a barbershop, I reckon they're the real McCoy.
Listen, hear the angels sing, a new king born today. And a man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
The shepherds watch the flocks by night to see a bright new shining star.
And then they hear our choir sing, music sing to come from afar.
Listen, hear the angels sing, a new king born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
I said a man
will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Made me a little bit teary because it was so very, very beautiful to listen to you singing in this gorgeous place. Thank you so much. It's really, really Christmassy. Do you like Christmas?
I love Christmas.
What is it you like about Christmas?
I think it's everything. I think it's the joy.
Yeah.
And all the people coming together.
Yeah, it is. Everything. It's about that kind of feeling of love and joy and...
acceptance.
Oh, please stop. Please stop. You're making me weep. I've got to get back on the ship and dry my eyes a bit, but you're all gorgeous and lovely. And happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas,
you gorgeous, gorgeous people. Oh, for goodness sakes, my heart. Do you know why I love cruising? Because it's like a taster menu of different places. I hopped off the ship in Stavanger, and it's been a roller coaster of emotions. But I'm leaving with so many happy memories. As the Vikings say, roar! Back on the ship.
We're setting sail again, but it's a bit choppy today.
There's nothing I like more than a glorious wind in my face as I'm wandering around a ship. It's kind of like, do you remember old Star Trek, where they would pretend that they'd been shot or something, and they all went... That's what it's like getting from A to B.
Now I've found my sea legs and the ship is starting to feel like home. But I'd like it to feel even more like Christmas.
Something you might not know about me is I love crafting. And I think my cabin and the ship need a few more decorations. So I'm going to find some elves to help me out. Because what's better than homemade?
So I've roped in my new sailing buddies.
Hello, how are you all? I wondered, loaded question, would you like to do some crafting with me?
I can't think of anything nicer.
Absolutely.
I'm sure you can, but I've got my glasses with me for this. Now, I've got a selection of different things and you can choose. So I've got some paper chains. Yeah. You take them, you take the paper chains. Here's one I made earlier.
Wow. It's like blue pizza.
Yes, exactly. So, do you remember what it was like to have children coming home with appalling
homemade school gifts for you.
Yeah. Yes.
You had to be a very good actor and pretend it was the most marvellous thing in the world.
So the kids would help you decorate the tree?
Oh, yes, yes, mm-hmm. with great gusto. But, you know, because they were so short, everything was round the bottom of the tree.
Yes, well, my entire family are under 5 foot, so yeah. We had a very heavily decorated tree at the bottom. Right, let's see where we've got to. I want everyone to hold up what they've done. You have done incredibly well. Look at that pom-pom, it's nearly done.
Well, there's a bit of straggly bits.
Now, feel free to take some of these back to your cabin to finish them. But I had an idea, and I wondered if you wanted to join in with me. Mm. I love a secret Santa.
Yeah.
It'd be a homemade secret Santa, so we'd have to make things for each other. Would you join me?
Yes.
Okay, right.
Yeah.
With all the names written down and put in Santa's stocking, which of my new mates will be lucky enough to get a present from me?
Now, does everyone know who they're
yes.
doing it for?
Yes.
Someone's going to get something very special.
Indeed.
Just this. No, I'll do something better than that. So we'll meet up again, yes?
OK.
And exchange presents.
Right.
OK, great.
No pressure.
After a present-planning morning, we arrive in Orlison. And who better to join me on a popular excursion than fellow traveller Alison and her friend Pamela?
What's your step? Come on, Pamela! Come on!
Orlison has its own mountain called Axla, which apparently offers some breathtaking views of the harbour. So hopefully this minibus will take us right to the top.
We are driving you to the Axla Mountain. Not at the top, we are dropping you off at the stairways. And then you will have a joyful walk up to the 480 steps to the viewpoint. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you. Well, that's a lot of steps, isn't it?
How many? 480?
480. Small steps.
Small steps. Like, come as if there were big steps, I wasn't going to do it.
With my new friends in tow, we quickly establish base camp on our epic adventure to the summit of Mount Axla.
Right, the steps. Now, how are you feeling about it?
Well, I think I can make it.
I know yeah. you can make it. I understand there's a cafe at the top, so as a treat, when we get to the top, we'll have a nice hot drink, OK?
Lovely.
Yes.
Shall we go for it?
OK. Let's go.
Come on, don't run away.
It's soon apparent the only way I'm going to make it up this mountain is if I get my head down and power on.
Oh, that was my knees. My knees have gone already.
Looks like I'll have to get the hot chocolate orders in for my pals.
Right, see you at the top, ladies. There are a lot of steps. I know, thank you, madam. Thank you, I can do it. I can do it. I'm a Scot. That means nothing. There's steps. It's not porridge.
But I won't be the first person to reach the summit. Plenty of my shipmates have beaten me to the top.
All right. No, no.
Honestly, it's worth it. It's lovely.
Okay, delighted. Okay. Nailing this. Absolutely nailing this. Nearly there. Nearly there.
I made it. What a jaw-dropping view of our ship and all of Orlison below.
It's gorgeous. It's quite magical. When I was thinking about Norway, this is the kind of winter wonderland I was thinking of.
All that's left is for my climbing companions, Pamela and Alison, to reach the peak.
Brought them a hot chocolate as a promise, as a treat for making it to the top. I have every faith that they're going to make it.
We did it.
And there they come. Come on in. Congratulations. Yay. I brought you a hot chocolate.
Oh, thank
hot
you.
Chocolate. Yeah. Here's to a beautiful walk up yes. 400 odd yes. steps, and we did it.
Yes.
We did cheers, it. Cheers.
Lovely.
Oh, that's lovely.
Worth every step.
Absolutely. Worth every step. We are warriors. We are brilliant. Right. Come on then, stop. We have to get back down.
Only joking.
I think they hate me.
The view from the top of Mount Axla is enough to make your heart soar. And the 418 steps are definitely enough to make your muscles sore.
It's been an absolutely smashing day, and one of the best things about it is I don't need to go to the gym ever again.
Coming up, someone needs to take my drink away.
Get drunk, please. I'm a very cheated.
And the Lofoten Islands take my breath away.
It is magnificent.
We are halfway through the first leg of our wonderfully Christmassy cruise up the Norwegian coast. We visited the southern ports of Stavanger and Orlesen. And now we're heading almost 350 nautical miles north to Rena on the far western tip of the famous Lofoten Island Peninsula. These magical islands sit well within the Arctic Circle and are considered one of the most beautiful places on Earth. I'm up early to prepare for my trip to the Lofoten Islands by getting first dibs on a proper breakfast. Santa style, naturally.
Now, one of the greatest things about cruising is the breakfast buffet. I love a buffet. If you have a party and tell me that the buffet is the food situation, I am there 3 hours early to make sure I have the best seat. I'm so excited.
And who can blame me? Just look at all this.
Morning.
I'm not sure where to start.
You've got your cheeses, you've got your vegetables, camembert, I mean fancy. Ooh, smoked Arctic char. What is that?
It's the Norwegian version of a salmon.
Yes, please.
Well, I love salmon. I'll give it a go.
Could I have a couple of fried eggs over easy and a couple of hash browns?
Of course you can. We'll bring them to the table for you.
Now, what else?
Fruit. Let's pretend to be healthy.
That'll do me for now.
I'll take my seat. Ooh, thanks very much indeed. That's the morning here done. Coffee, most important thing. Get myself a cup of... Come on, Susan, don't spill it. Oh. OK, so this is the char, which is apparently like salmon. Trying new things, Susan, being very brave. Very nice, very much like salmon. I enjoyed that very much. Just one wee bit. All right, I'll go back to... Don't worry. And remember, it is a buffet. You can go back more than once. And in that way, breakfast can last 10 minutes, an hour, or even, if you're very good at this, until lunchtime.
Not today, though, with so much Nordic adventure on offer. We're about to be dropped off at Rena, a tiny island fishing village. And then our cruise ship will collect us later, further up the coast in Svalvi.
It's very exciting.
And it's finally happening. The one thing I've been dreaming of to make this trip even more festive.
It's our first snow of our Norwegian Christmas cruise, and it's absolutely amazing.
There are plenty of organised excursions on offer, but I'm planning a solo adventure to the village of Kabelvord for a Christmas shopping trip with a difference.
Thank you. As we were driving in, I saw this incredible view and I had to stop and take a look. And I'm so glad I did. It is magnificent.
Kabelvord itself is incredibly pretty. But the temperature's below zero, so it's too cold to explore for long. I'm heading indoors.
I'm just getting the snow off.
Artist Katinka Malam creates unique glass objects inspired by Lofoten's natural beauty. She specialises in all shapes and sizes. And today she'll be helping me make a Calman-sized bauble of my very own.
So these are the aurora balls. When the light comes through them, yeah, you can see the northern light dancing on the wall.
They're absolutely stunning.
Katinka has been working with glass for 25 years. Looks a bit dangerous if you ask me.
What are we actually making?
We are making a little Christmas decoration to put on the tree.
You've got very steady hands.
You have to have ice in your stomach.
See, I've got fire in my stomach. I'm a passionate Scottish Scorpio. That's the problem. There's nothing calm. That's beautiful already.
We Scorpios are also very intuitive, and I feel this isn't going to be as easy as Katinka makes it look.
Please stay near.
I'm here all the time.
Okay. I'm sweating, and it's not the heat. Is that okay?
You can just keep it in the flame and turn.
Okay, and turn it.
And breathe.
Yeah. Now I put this in?
Yes. Okay. And then you put it on the glass and push.
And then we turn it. Okay, I'm liking that. It's a little bit lopsided, but I think that's kind of like myself.
No one is perfect.
No one is perfect. This looks cool.
It's very nice.
I can see what you mean, though. If you just breathe and relax, it's actually a really beautiful thing because you're watching the glass change and the colours change and everything else.
Look at that.
Oh, I'm so proud. It may be small, but it is mighty, much like myself. What a wonderfully calming, beautiful experience that was. And as a bonus, I think I've nailed my secret Santa. That is quite the gift.
The experiences I'm having on this cruise are as memorable as the scenery is beautiful. And I've so much more to discover. The cruise ship pickup point at Svalvi is just a few miles north. Lofoten's largest city has a small town feel, with fewer than 5,000 residents. It's time to meet one of them over a drink. And luckily, there's a local brewery.
Well, it's like blind date. Hello.
Welcome.
Hiya.
Welcome.
I know this is really cheeky, but I wondered if I could have a look around your brewery.
Most definitely.
Is that okay? Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, darling. Bachelor number one.
Andreas is part of the small Lofot Pills Brewery. Started by his father, it prides itself on creating beers said to embody the taste of Lofoten.
What is it about this place that makes the drink you make special?
That's, of course, water. We have really, really soft water. So water is just from the mountains there, so it's water that's continually reused, so there's not so many minerals inside.
We've got really soft water in Glasgow.
Yeah?
Do you know what's good about it? It makes your hair all foamy. You know, when you wash your hair, you get loads of froth on it.
Does it?
And in the run-up to Christmas, the microbrewery produces extra special festive brews that go well with all sorts of Christmas dishes.
Every year, we fill around 500 of these 2-litre grovelers for Christmas.
So I put this in here.
Yeah.
Drinking ale at this time of year is a centuries-old tradition in Norway.
Close it.
In fact, it was once illegal not to celebrate Christmas with a beer.
2 litre?
Yep. Very good. You hired.
Thank you very much. Oh, that's a thing of beauty. 2 litres. It's about 4 pints.
Yeah.
That's what I call a good night, Andrew.
Oh, yeah.
9, 8, 9, 9, 2. Oh, yeah.
And to finish off, a lovely festive label.
Don't mess it up, Susan. Don't mess it up. It's slightly squint. It's like the biggest bottle of beer in the world. We're one of the smallest people in the world. I'll obviously take this with me, but before we go, can we have a wee tipple?
Of course.
Just try it. Try it before we go.
Of course.
Right, what's the first one?
Thank you very much.
So this is an unfiltrated pilsner. So you see it's a light colour.
Yeah.
And then you go for the smell. It's a bready style.
Yes.
And then you go for the taste.
Well, it's super like a lady.
Yes, that's good.
And that's very nice.
And straight to my head.
Next.
I want you to try out if you can taste the difference between a 4.7 beer and a 7% beer.
Concentrate, Calman. You can do this.
And the typical thing with a Christmas beer in Norway is that it's darker.
Tastes chocolatey.
Yeah. And this comes from the malt.
I get drunk really easily. I'm a very cheap date.
Right, decision time.
I think this is the more alcoholic one.
You're correct. You're correct.
But just to be sure.
Okay.
Another snifter.
I think I need to leave now.
Luckily, the ship is just 50 meters
away. The ship's just over there. Just take my wee bottle of beer. Thanks very much, Andreas. You're an absolute superstar.
Thank you.
I genuinely lost my footing.
I've had a delightfully jam-packed day here in this stunning corner of Norway. But I must admit, seeing our majestic ship sailing into Svalvær is a beautiful and welcome sight.
Woo! Hello! Oh, they're all waving! Oh, it's so lovely! Oh, Captain Eric! Hey, Captain! Honk, honk!
The ship is my home from home, and I can't wait to get cosy. After dinner, the crew have laid on a warming treat. Mulled wine and hot tea. I'm in.
Hello. Good evening. Hi. Could I have a cup of tea?
Definitely.
Yes, thank you. Lovely fruit tea. Thank you very much indeed.
Enjoy.
Thank you very much. Hello, do you mind if I join you? Thanks very much indeed. Cheers. So tell me, how have you been enjoying the cruise?
It's been super.
Yeah?
Great fun.
Why did you pick this type of cruise to come on? Because this is quite an outdoorsy, active one.
Just wanted to do something different. I hadn't done it before, not been to Norway.
So are you quite outdoorsy?
Very outdoorsy, yeah. I cycle, so I've been going to the gym.
So have I.
Haven't seen you in there.
Well, that's... Maybe we just like to go different times. How far do you like to cycle?
20K.
20K. I do 40. See you in the gym.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll see you. I'll see you. I'll see you in the gym.
I'm glad I had that warm cuppa, because apparently there's something coming up I don't want to miss.
The captain is going to try and get us just to the entrance to one of the fjords in the hope that we might see something spectacular. It's very exciting.
We are right next to the Trollfjord, a famous natural wonder. It's named after trolls, terrifying creatures from Norse mythology said to dwell in these mountains and caves. With the help of these searchlights, we're all hoping to see one tonight.
This is what a cruise like this is about. Doesn't matter if it's a bit cold, wrapping up warm, and seeing things like this. I mean, look how close we are to these incredible mountains. It has a searchlight so that we can see how beautiful things are. It's so calm, the sea. It's flat as glass. And it is just quite unbelievable.
Come Coming up, I meet Santa's furry helpers.
They're so gentle, aren't they?
What happened there?
And play Secret Santa to my new friends.
Yes. Oh, it's mine!
That is beautiful. Oh.
We are heading further and further north on my Christmas cruise of a lifetime, sailing up the Norwegian coast aboard our trusty ship. I've met some amazing people. And I've seen some breathtaking sights.
It's spectacular.
Our next stop is 168 nautical miles further north, Tromsø, known as the gateway to the Arctic. Here, it snows on average for 7 months of the year.
Come on, everyone. Let's go on a day trip. Oh, wow. It's another amazing snowy day, and I'm off to do something really Christmassy with my new friends from the ship.
We're going to meet some of Santa's furry friends. Around 300 of them at a Sami camp. The Sami are Norway's indigenous people, and their language and culture is protected. They even have their own parliament.
All the people we've met in Norway have been so lovely.
Yes, just...
I love the idea that a Viking nation is one of the sweetest that I've ever met.
Our guide, Johan, is a descendant of these traditional nomadic people.
Hello, my friend.
Welcome to our place.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you guys want to help me feed the reindeers?
Love that, if that's okay.
Thank you.
Yes.
I have some buckets here. This is the lichen.
The lichen?
Yeah, lichen. The reindeers love this.
Hi, baby. How are you doing? Just pour it?
Yeah, pour it.
Okay.
Yeah. They're already coming.
They are already coming. There you go.
And here for you guys.
Okay, thank you.
Perhaps there's a reindeer herder in all of us.
Ooh. Oh, you got it.
He's taking a shot.
Oh, yeah.
Then again, perhaps not.
For the Sami people, the indigenous peoples, they've always been very important, haven't they?
Yes, you know, the reindeers, they are really like providing us for everything. The clothing, the meat, and nowadays, money. In a way, it's like the wheel in the family. Everything is like spinning around the herd.
They're fencing us.
Take care of the actors and your eyes.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm doing. Reindeers are the most gentle animals. I'm not frightened of reindeers. I want to make that clear to anyone watching. It's the main thing. Tell me about their hooves.
The hoof of the reindeer, it's like spreading out.
Like snowshoes almost.
It's so almost like snowshoes.
Yeah.
Do you hear the noise
the
inside?
Clicking.
Yeah, the clicking. That's what happens when they're walking and the hooves are like going out. So.
Do you hear that clicking?
Yeah, you can, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's like a very cozy noise. It's like I'm like relaxing when I hear.
When
the
you
noise.
Hear it.
Yeah, when I hear the noise.
So how does it feel being this close to these beautiful creatures?
Yeah, I never thought I'd be this close to a reindeer.
Yeah.
I thought they were more wild, if you like, not as gentle as they are.
They're so gentle.
They are, aren't they?
What happened there?
They had a ride.
Angela was almost off there on a reindeer.
You know, my wife used to say the reindeers have gone into your mind. That's correct.
Yeah.
I spend more time with the reindeers than I do with my wife.
I'm now frozen to the core, so thank goodness we've been invited into a traditional Sami shepherd's tent, or lavu, to warm up by the fire.
Oh, that's nice. That's very nice indeed.
Yeah, welcome into my lavu.
Thank you. One of the things that I know from being here, it can get quite dark. What would you do of an evening with your family?
I don't know if you have heard about the joik, the Sami way of music.
Is there any way that we could hear something?
I give it a try.
Yes.
Hey, la 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 la.
I can't think of a much more Christmassy scene than this. The snow and Rudolph's friends. I've shared the cosy warmth of the fire with the Sami people. But what I'm really going to take away from it is what you can hear, which is the comforting clicking of the reindeers. And for me, that's going to be the sound of Christmas.
Back on board, and it's time to play Secret Santa with my shipmates. And nobody knows who's made which gift.
So this is... Oh, it's mine! Beautiful, isn't it? Wow. Whoever that was, thank you so much. Right, next up, Rachel. Adrian.
That's
really posh.
Wow.
Well, isn't it?
What's that?
Oh, look at that. Isn't that gorgeous?
Oh, wow.
Wow.
I think this could be your fair ham.
Mm-hmm.
That must have taken them a very long time.
Stan. Happy Christmas. Oh! And Janet.
Oh, my Christmas trees. Oh, they're beautiful.
Well, thank you so much for joining in with my Secret Santa. It's been such a pleasure. Shall we have a skål?
We shall.
Skål. Yes.
Merry Christmas. Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas.
A Viking toast to friendship. And at this special time of year, it makes me think of everyone back home. All I want for Christmas is you. I step into Christmas in Norway's beautiful snowy landscape.
We're at the top of Europe!
It's a fairy tale of the Arctic.
We are actually sailing through ice.
And I'm on a winter wonderland ride I'll never forget.
This is the most Christmassy thing I have ever done in my entire life.
And Susan's back with all that brand new tomorrow at 9. Find out how the other half shop for the festive season as we take a peek inside Harrods at Christmas, brand new at 8 tomorrow. And tonight, from breathing problems to broken bones, every second counts in Casualty 24/7, coming up next.